Sir, you have a master's in philosophy and English. You
no,
have
master's
a,
in business
no,
management.
No, no, you have a, yeah, you're a major in philosophy
Fidator,
and
yes.
master's in business management yes. from the AIM.
Yes.
Maybe you can tell us what put you on the track of the paranormal.
Well, it's a long story, and very briefly, there was an experience I had which I couldn't explain from a scientific standpoint, so I had to look for an explanation.
This
and,
is, of
and I
course.
Found it in something that's beyond, and I have proof. But it's something that I don't expect people to believe. I'm not interested in convincing people. It was the personal experience I had. I have my own reasons for doing so. And I can prove it if they are willing to listen, but it will take time. So I'd rather not talk about it. But there was an experience which is so extraordinary that it's beyond science.
Okay. But sir, please do talk
oh,
about
wow.
it.
I mean, oh, no, okay. we're interested.
No. It was 1975. I joined a group of an American seminar. I was brought here from Australia by two Americans, Bettina Lohmann and Nancy Siebert. I still remember the names. Mm. And they were supposed to introduce us to human energies, energy fields, mm. and also to know your spirit guides and angels. So I was curious. It was out of curiosity. There were 15 of us. One of the exercises included somebody to be sitting at the center with their eyes closed, and then people will be at 1 foot away, will move their hands to the left or right with the instruction of the teacher. The first two guys did not feel anything. So I was the third person to sit there, so I was not expecting anything. Mm. When they started moving their hands from left to right, I said, your hands are moving from, I could feel the energy very strongly. Mm. Your hands are moving to the left, my hands are moving from top to bottom. When they started moving their hands from the bottom up, I started feeling something at the pit of my stomach, moving like this. It was something like you're about to throw up. Mm. So I said, stop, stop, at the top of my voice, but nothing was coming out. I didn't know that until later. It was silent. So they kept on moving their hands like this, no? until it went here, and then only air came up. The next thing I knew, I was cataleptic like this, and then I fell like this.
Nakadilat kayo the whole time?
No, I was, my eyes were closed all along.
How then, do you know that they weren't touching you? How do you know that they were completely...
You know, that's a very interesting thing. When I look back to it, I could see with my eyes closed. I thought I was just feeling it at that time. Hmm. But looking back, I said, you know, I could see. Kumutik na ako maduterin.
Oo nga. Oh, but ito, let me be the cynic.
No, it's okay with me.
Yeah, yeah.
I enjoy skeptics.
Okay nga, but ito yung ano ko. Iwan nakapikit kayo. So you don't really actually know at that time kung hinahawakan kayo or hindi. You're saying,
no,
looking back
no, because,
now.
Yeah, because no, they were instructed to be at 1 foot away.
Yeah.
They were instructed.
Yeah. But so how do you know? Nakapikit kayo.
No, but oh my God, there are 15 people who were there. They will know.
But there are a lot of stories like that, actually. They call it astral projection.
Exactly what happened. The next thing I knew, I was at the ceiling,
yeah.
looking down at my body. Mm-hmm. And I could
okay,
see
okay,
the Bettina Lohmann of my... Like, how? What am I doing here?
You remember this?
I definitely.
You remember looking
not
down.
Only remember, if you want me to continue the story.
Yeah.
So I was there, so I was not afraid. Then when I looked here, I could see very clearly the face of the Pitindoma. How could I see when it's just at my back? And mm-hmm. I was in the ceiling, and I could see 360 degrees. So I know what it looks like when you're in the astral field, you can see 360 degrees. Mm-hmm. And then I tuned into different people. I could read their minds, each one of them. My wife was there. And the mother of Chinchin Gutierrez was also in that group, no? Mm. Who was my assistant before. And after that, Bettina Lam started snapping her fingers near my ear. Mm. It was very far, and then it became nearer, 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 until I opened my eyes, and I laughed at them. Hey, I saw all of you. And then so they realized I didn't have a heart attack. Yeah. Then I said, what happened? And then Bettina Lohmann said, oh, you were having a trip. What do you mean? Oh, you were having a trip. What do you mean
having a trip?
I had to pay another fee for her to explain what happened to me. It was astral projection. Yeah. I had to pay. I didn't know anything about it. I was completely ignorant about this. Mm. So I research. Mm. Then I go out of my body once in a while.
You still do?
I still do, but not as much as 10 years ago.
You can do it on your own, or does it have to have somebody?
Usually involuntary.
Involuntary?
But there was one or two times, it was voluntary, but I couldn't do it.
What would you call that? A trance or
No, it's actually astral projection or out-of-body experience. Hmm. There's a lot of scientific evidence for this. Robert Monroe, who's an engineer, established an institute, the Monroe Institute, where he teaches He taught people how to go out of their body. Yeah. And people have gone out of the body when they are asleep. They could see their physical body there. They thought they're dead. Mm. See? And they could not move. That's why medical people said it's sleep paralysis. It's not sleep paralysis. It's astral projection.
Is this specific to certain people only, or
no,
can anybody
no.
do this?
It happens to everybody. But most of the time when we are asleep, we go out of our body, we are not aware of it. But sometimes we wake up. When we are there, that's why we get scared, because you can see your physical body lying there, but you're out. That's astral projection.
It's not just a nightmare?
No, iba yon.